I put my machine in front of Freddie, start the interview, so can we start, Freddie? Oh, yes, come on, what do you want to know? And I looked at the machine and the red light wasn't on. And I said, oh, Freddie, just a moment. I said, I'm worried. He said, what is it, darling? So I tested. Oh, I said, oh, my God, I'm so embarrassed, Freddie. The battery is flat. I couldn't believe it. Ah, was I angry. Anyway, he was wonderful. He got his manager to rush around the hotel somewhere and get new batteries. We started all over again. I don't know many artists that would be that comfortable about doing that again.
What is your attitude to life?
I don't know. Actually, at this point in time, I think it's just having a good time, to be honest, yeah. I was caught up in, you know, being successful and being a star and all that, and I thought, this is the way a star behaves or whatever. Now I don't give a damn. You know, I don't give a damn. I want to do things my way and I want to have fun.
I was in Chelsea in a restaurant. I bumped into Freddie with all his friends around him, and he was sitting there with Kenny Everett and people like that. As I passed by, Freddie just said to me, David, oh, I love your Beatles stuff. You haven't interviewed me yet. Why not? So what a great invitation. So I said, well, yes, why not? I would love to. When could we do it? So he said, well, ring my office and come to one of the gigs and I'd be happy to do an interview with you. So it was a very easygoing introduction. The first interview I did was actually in Manchester. So I went to the concert and I went backstage and Mary was there. And they were roaring, calling him back for more. And he came out of the side platform of the stage into the dressing room, picked up an iron and threw it through the full-length mirror that he dressed in front of earlier. And I said, Freddie, gosh, you're obviously not superstitious. That's 7 years bad luck in my family. He said, well, that means I've got another 7 years to live, haven't I, David? But of course, he was fit then. I said, what's wrong? And Mary said, what's wrong, Freddie? We were not good enough tonight. My microphone was popping. And that is bad. We are number one and we have to be the best. That's what it was like. But I said, but Freddie, they're calling you back now. He said, I know. And I want them to have the best of us. Extraordinary, isn't it? I did one filmed interview in Munich, and he didn't want to go around the world. He wanted just to do one big interview. He said, oh, get David over. So they flew me over.
Okay, brilliant, David. Yeah.
Shoot, David.
Shoot, right.
Always professional, but very strong-willed. You couldn't tell him what to do.
In Brazil, do you have a message for the stations in Brazil?
Well, Brazil is... I think we've been there twice, and then Brazil is like home.
He could get bored. I mean, when we did the one in Munich, they wanted him to say, hello, Hong Kong, hello, Australia, I'll be with you soon, all that. Well, after about doing four countries, he'd had enough.
And do you have a message for the stations in France?
Oh. And he would say, oh, F so-and-so. They said, we can't put that in.
And do you have a message for the stations in Mexico?
No.
And of course the director came and said, can we take that again, please? But you could not tell Freddie what to do.
I don't give a
His memory was incredible. If you happened to veer into a question you'd asked before, he'd say, oh, you asked me that last time, David.
But on stage, you give this impression that you're quite a formidable individual, Freddie.
I am.
Freddie had this amazing sense of humour, a very camp sense of humour, which was very funny to everybody. He looked for life all the time. Every day, he wanted to live life to the full, and he did.
I'm not afraid to speak out and say things that I want to do or do the things that I want to do. So I think in the end, being natural and being actually genuine is what wins. And I hope that comes out in my songs.
When I discovered, he told me that he was not very well, but we all hoped, you know, there would be some drug come along and save him, like so many people at that time. And I said to him, I said, well, so how would you like to be remembered, Freddie? What would you like to be remembered? And that's what I think the fans picked up on. He genuinely loved the fans. He said, I would just like to be remembered for having brought some happiness into somebody's life. Now, simple, but isn't that is the true man?
Yes, well, we better move on.